Good morning, students. In this session, we'll discuss the NCERT problem on the basis of capacitors. First problem: a parallel plate capacitor with air within the plates has capacitance of 8 picofarad. What is the numerical? A parallel plate capacitor with the air between the plates has capacitance of 8 picofarad. What will be the capacitance if the distance between the plates is reduced by half and space between them will be the substance of dielectric constant 6? Students, we know that capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor in air between the plates and capacitance of the capacitor with the dielectric constant between the plates. Right? Let us see the solution. What has given? So the solution. First of all, we will write the given values. What are the given values? We will see one by one. See here. Capacitance of the capacitor in air between the plates. How much has given? 8 picofarad. 8 picofarad. Then a dielectric constant is given. That is 6 is given. Right? What is saying? What will the capacitance if the distance between the plates is reduced by half? I mean, he has given D dash. D dash equal to D by. Right? Then I need the new capacitance. Need the new capacitance here. First of all, let us see the capacitance of the capacitor in between the plates when it is filled with air or vacuum. What is the formula? C is equal to how much? C is equal to A epsilon naught divided by E. Right? C is equal to A into epsilon naught divided by E. Write the equation for that. C has given how much? 8 picofarad. What is asking? What is the capacitance if the distance between the plates are reduced by half? Reduced by half. And space between them is filled with the dielectric constant 6. See here, what is the condition? See here. Capacitance when it is filled with air or vacuum, then this is the equation now. But with the dielectric medium, how much it is? D dash. Here, what is A? A represents dielectric constant. Then what is D dash? The distance between the plate is reduced by half. So let us fill this. What we get? C dash equal to A into epsilon naught into K. What is D dash? D dash equal to D by 2. That 2 was upside. Look at me, A epsilon naught divided by D, that is what we are looking at, picofarad. Theta picofarad. Shall we write this? How to write? C dash equal to A epsilon naught divided by D, A picofarad. K, A how much? That is 6. Right? Into 2 by. Right? Then what will we do directly? C dash equal to, 96 picofarad. You will get 96 picofarad. When the distance is half, space between them is filled with the dielectric constant 6. This equation will get. Then finally, what is the new capacitance? New capacitance is 96 picofarad. Pico mean 10 raised to minus 4. So, just check the problem, we will see one more. Second vehicle. Three capacitors, each of capacitance 9 picofarad, connected in series. Option A, what is the total capacitance of the combination? Option B, what is the potential difference across each capacitor if the combination is connected to over 20 volts of current? Students, we know that when capacitors are connected in series and capacitors are connected in parallel. When capacitors are connected in series, the total capacitance of the combination is given by 1 by Cs equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 up to so on you can see. And in series combination, across each capacitor charge remains same, but potential difference divides. Remember this point. Now what are the given values here? Let us see. Solution. Given values. What given values are there? Here capacitance C1 equal to C2 equal to C3. How much it is? 9 picofarad. Right? Then the and these connected by 120 volts of. What we need? Capacitance of the combination in option A, and we need potential difference across each capacitor. Potential difference across each capacitors. Better. First of all, let us see option A. What is the total capacitance of the combination when capacitors are connected in series? In series, what is the formula? 1 divided by Cs equal to 1 divided by C1 plus 1 divided by C2 plus 1 divided by C3. How much? Then 1 divided by C is equal to 1 by 9 picofarad plus 1 divided by 9 picofarad plus 1 divided by 9 picofarad. How much will you get directly? Cs equal to 9 divided by 3. Cs equal to 9 divided by 3. That's here. What is the total capacitance of the combination? Cs equal to how much? Cs equal to 3 picofarad. And capacitors are connected in series. The total capacitance of the combination is given by 9 picofarad. Then we need again potential difference across each capacitor. First of all, when three capacitors are connected in series, what is the charge across each capacitor? We need to calculate that. We know this formula. Total capacitance is equal to total charge divided by total potential. Right? Then, what is the total charge? Total charge is equal to total capacitance into voltage. Right? Total capacitance into voltage. How much will you get? Total charge Q. See, S how much? S is equal to 3 picofarad. Pico mean 10 raised to minus 12. V how much? 120. Then how much will be directly? Q equal to 360 into 10 raised to minus 12. What it is? The total charge. Total charge across the combination. And this total charge remains same across each plates of the capacitor. Right? Then let us see the option B. In the option B, what is given? What is the potential difference across each capacitor when the combination is connected to 120 volts of power? Remember, this is option A. Which is option A. Then option B, what is asking? See here. We need a potential difference across each combination. See here. Capacitance is equal to charge divided by voltage. Then what is the capacitor? What is the voltage? Voltage is equal to charge divided by capacitance. See here how to write. V1 equal to total charge divided by capacitance. Right? Then how to calculate? See, total charge how much? Total charge is equal to 360. 360 into 10 raised to minus 12. Capacitance C1 equal to C3 equal to C3 how much? 9 picofarad. 9 into how much? 10 raised to minus 12. Pico mean minus 12. This one cancel, then how much we get? V1 equal to 40. V1 equal to 40. Then similarly, we need V2 and V3. V2 and V3. Again, we need to formulate. What is V2? V2 equal to total charge divided by capacitance C2. Right? What is total charge? How much? 360 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by C2 again. 9 into 10 raised to minus 2, how much V2 will get? V2 equal to again, that is 40 volt. Right? V2. Then what about V3? Again, V3 can be written like this. See here. V3 is equal to C1 divided by C3. What is Q again? 360 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by C3, how much? 9 into 10 raised to minus 2 minus 1 by C3 cancel. Again, what is V3? V3 equal to again 40. Right? See here? Across C1, how much potential difference? 40 volt. Across C2, 40 volt. Across C3, 40 volt. Add this total potential. That V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. 40 plus 40 plus 40, you will get to 120. Then from this, what you got? When capacitors are connected in series, across each capacitor, potential difference divided by charge across each capacitor means. Right? Just copy this problem, we'll see one more. capacitors of capacitance 2 picofarad, 3 picofarad and 4 picofarad are connected in parallel. Right? Option A. What is the capacitance of the combination? Option B. Determine charge on each capacitor if the combination is connected to a filtered load supply. Students, the three capacitors are connected in parallel. Right? What are the given values? See here. Let us see this over here. Given values. Given. Capacitance C1 given. How much? That is the 2 picofarad. Right? Capacitance C2 given. How much? 3 picofarad. Then what about capacitance C3? Capacitance C3 equal to 4 picofarad. Right? We need in option A total capacitance across the combination. Right? In option B, what is given? Determining charge on each capacitor is the combination. Charge on each capacitor means we need given. Right? We need Q2. Similarly, what we need? We need Q3. When the combination is connected to by what supplier? When the combination is connected to 100 volt supply. Right? Let us see in option A. What is the capacitance of the combination? See here, when capacitors are connected in parallel, total capacitance of the combination is Cp equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 up to so on. The three capacitors are given. What is the capacitance of the combination? Capacitance of the combination is C1 plus C2 plus C3. C1 is 2 picofarad. C1 equal to 2 picofarad. C2 equal to 3 picofarad. C3 equal to 4 picofarad. Then, how much you got? Total capacitance of the combination is 9 picofarad. That is 9 picofarad. Then, we need what is the total charge across this combination? Total charge, not individual charge. Individual charge will calculate later. See here. What is the total charge? Total capacitance equal to total charge divided by total potential difference. Right? What is the total charge? Total charge is equal to total capacitance into voltage. What is point? What is the total capacitance? Total capacitance is a 9 picofarad. 9 picofarad. Right? What is the voltage? Voltage, how much you have given? Voltage is equal to 100 volt. Directly, what is the total charge across this combination? Total charge across this combination Q equal to how much? Q equal to 9 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb. Right? Then, let us across capacitor C1, how much charge is distributed? We know that for C1. Let us see for C1. C1 equal to Q divided by how much? That is V. C1. Because in parallel combination, charge divides, potential difference remains same. See here. Then what is the total charge? Q1 equal to how much? Q1 equal to C1 into V. Right, this point. Look at it. C1 how much? 2 picofarad. 2 into 10 raised to minus 12 into how much? 100 V. Right? What about the C1? C1 how much? Q1 how much? Q1 equal to how much? This value. 2 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb. Across capacitor C1, how much charge developed? 2 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb charge developed. Similarly, across C2, how to write? C1 equal to Q1 by V. Similarly, for C2, directly shall write? Q2 equal to how much? Q2 equal to C2 into V. Q2 equal to C2 into V. What is C2? C2 is a 3 picofarad. 3 into 10 raised to minus 10. V and right. Then how much charge developed here? Q2 equal to how much charge developed? Charge developed can be given 3 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb. Right? See here. Charge level across C2. Similarly, across C3, can see how much it is. Q3 equal to what formula? Q3 equal to capacitance C3 into potential difference. Right? What is capacitance C3? 4 picofarad. How much you got? 4 into 10 raised to minus 12 into how much? 100. How much charge will develop? Q3 equal to 4 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb develop. Look at it. Across even how much charge develop? 2 into 10 raised to minus 10. Across C2, 3 into 10 raised to minus 7. Across C3, 4 into 10 raised to minus 10. Add all these values. So 2 plus 3 plus 4, how much it is again? That is 9 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb. What is the total charge? Where is the total charge? Total charge equal to this value. This value 9 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb. What it is? When three capacitors are connected in parallel, you can calculate the total capacitance and get the total charge along with the charge distributed across each capacitors. See for few seconds, we'll see one more. Next numerical is, in a parallel fed capacitor with air between the plates, each plate has an area 6 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter square and the distance between the plate is 3 mm. Distance between the plate is 3 mm. Calculate the capacitance of the capacitor. What is the charge on each plate of the capacitor if it is connected to a 100 volt supply? If it is connected to a 100 volt supply. See here, what is given? In a parallel plate capacitor with air between the plates, each plate has an area. Area of the capacitor is given. Area of the parallel plate capacitor is given. Distance between the plate is 3 mm. Distance between the plate is given. We need capacitance of the capacitor. See here, what is given in the solution? Let us see the solution. First of all, write the given values. What are the given values here? Area of each plate of the capacitor given. How much? A equal to 6 into 10 raised to how much? Minus 3 meter square. Later on, distance between the plate is given. Small d given. Small d equal to how much? 3 millimeter, millimeter, 10 to minus 3 meter. We need capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor and charge across each plate of the capacitor if the combination is connected to 100 volt supply. Right? Solution is very simple. We know that capacitance of parallel plate capacitor when in between the plates is filled with air or water. See here, what is the capacitance formula for parallel plate? A epsilon naught divided by D. Epsilon naught divided by D. Put all the values here. A given, A how much? 6 into 10 raised to minus 3. 6 into 10 raised to minus 3. Epsilon naught constant. 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 4. Whole divided by how much? D. D equal to 3 millimeter. Equal to 3 millimeter, right? Later on, this will get cancelled. Then what is the capacitance of this combination? Capacitance of this combination is 17.71 into 10 raised to minus 12 farad. This is what? Total capacitance of the combination. Then we need again total charge on the plates of capacitor when it is connected to 100 volt supply. See here, we know that capacitance formula. What is capacitance? Capacitance is equal to charge divided by voltage. Right? How much charge is there? Charge is equal to capacitance into voltage. Later on, look at it. See, already got it. C equal to 17 to minus 71 into 10 raised to minus 12 farad. V how much given? 100 volt is given. 100 volt. Then what is the total charge? Total charge equal to 17.71
into 10 raised to minus 10.
Across E plates of capacitor, charge is plus 17.71 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb and minus 17.71 into 10 raised to minus 10 coulomb across the positive plate and negative plate. So this is the solution for this problem. So copy. We'll see one more problem. Next numerical, the plates of parallel plate capacitor have an area 90 cm square each and separated by 2.5 mm. The capacitor is charged by connecting it to a 400 volt supply. How much energy stored in capacitor? What is asking? The plates of parallel plate capacitor have an area 90 cm square. What area given? 90 cm. 90 cm means 10 raised to minus 2 cm square means 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Area 90 cm or 90 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Are separated by 2.5 mm. Separated by 2.5 mm. 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2. Right? If the capacitor is charged by connecting 100 volt supply, it is connected by 100 volt supply. How much energy stored in the capacitor? What we need? Energy stored in the capacitor. Students, we know that energy stored in the capacitor, that is equal to half CV square. Equal to half CV square. What is energy stored in capacitor? Energy stored in capacitor is equal to half CV square. Right? In this formula, V given, 400 volt is given, but I need capacitance. Right? Shall we work? This is equation number 1. Write out. We know that capacitance of parallel plate capacitor in air between the plates. What is the formula? Capacitance of parallel plate capacitor A epsilon naught divided by V. Let out A how much? A equal to 90 into 10 raised to minus 4. 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by V. A how much? 2.5 milli. Milli means 10 raised to minus 4. Convert all these values. How much capacitance will get? Capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor is 31.86 into 10 raised to minus 1. What it is? Capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. In this capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor, how much energy is stored? Shall we call this? This is equation number 2. Very simple, put equation 2 in equation 1. We'll get the energy stored in the capacitor. How much energy is stored in the capacitor? Half. See how much? 31.86 into 10 raised to minus 4. V square, how much V? V equal to 400. 400 how to write? 4 into 10 raised to 2. In C square, how much? 16 into 10 raised to 10 raised to 4. Put all these values. How much energy will get? Energy equal to 2.55 into 10 raised to 4. How much energy stored between the plates of capacitor? Energy stored between the plates of capacitor is 2.55 into 10 raised to minus 6 joule. Copy this problem, we will see one more problem. Last numerical is, a 12 picofarad capacitor is connected to 50 volt battery. What it is? A 12 picofarad capacitor is connected to 12 volt battery. How much electrostatic energy is stored in the capacitor? How much electrostatic energy is stored in the capacitor? Direct formula is there. Cl. What are the given values? Capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor given 12 picofarad. Right? Connected to 50 volt battery supply. V equal to 50 volt. Equal to 50 volt. We need energy stored between the plates of capacitor. Students, energy stored in the capacitor is given. Energy stored between the plates of capacitor equal to half C V square. Write it out. Yes, C given and V given. Directly we can get the energy. How much energy we got? Half C. 12 picofarad. 12 into 10 raised to minus 1. 50. Right. 50 whole square. Write it out. Then how much will be directly? CL. 6 times. How much? 6 into 10 raised to minus 12. How much it is? 2500. Right? How much energy will get the directly? Energy stored between the plates of capacitor is 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. In between the plates of capacitor, the energy stored is given by 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. See this problem? Thank you.